Scamper Theatre Kids, Scamper Theatre Kids.
Come act with us and join in our adventure. It's time to sing and dance and play pretend. You can be the star of your own story. Your imagination is a lifelong.
We have one rule. You must be silly.
Repeat after me. I promise. To be super silly.
Super silly.
For this entire class.
Scamper Theatre Kids. Scamper Theatre Kids. Jazz hands.
Now can we have ice cream?
Shake your sillies out. Shake your sillies out. Wiggle your waggles away. You gotta freeze your freezies out. You gotta freeze your freezies out. You gotta freeze your freezies out. And wiggle your waggles away. You gotta feel real shy inside. You gotta feel real shy inside. You gotta feel real shy inside. And wiggle your waggles away. You gotta race your race cars out. You gotta race your race cars out. You gotta race your race cars out. And wiggle your waggles away. You gotta shake your sillies out. Shake your sillies out. Shake your sillies out. Wiggle your waggles away.
Hi, everybody. Over here. Hi, everybody. Up here again. Still up here. Oh, it's charades time! Wow! All right, so Brooke is gonna show you a picture of something, and then you are gonna pretend to be what's on that picture, and then I am gonna try and guess what you are being. Are you ready? Let's play! All right. Flying, flapping. Oh, are you a helicopter? No, okay. Are you a fly? Oh, am I close? All right. I think I know. Are you a bee? Yes, you guys are amazing bees. All right, next up. All right. Swinging something. Okay, swinging something. Are you a golf club? No, okay. A tennis racket! Are you a mountain lion? No, okay. I thought it was a good guess. All right, a baseball bat. All right, next up. Okay, I think you are a sleeping bunny. No, okay. Are you a bed? No. Okay. I don't know. Do you eat this? You do? Are you a hamburger? Are you a hot dog? Yes! Awesome! All right.
Go to sleep, you're gonna go to sleep. Then I will sprinkle my magic sleeping potion on you, and when I say wake up, you will magically transform into whatever animal I turn you into. So, go to sleep. All right, this animal is really fast. It has a really long tail, a long mane. Any guesses? It's a horse! Let me see you move like a horse. How does a horse move fast? Yes. Mane blowing in the wind. And now eat an apple like a horse. Good. Nay. And go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep. This animal is something we did in one of our books, Spencer and Vincent. Do you remember what Spencer and Vincent were? They were jellyfish. Wake up! Let me see you bloop, 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 bloop. The jellyfish, let me see you jellyfish around like just a blobber. Blob, blob, blob. Blah, blah, blah. Very good, and go to sleep. And this next animal is one of my favorite woodland creatures who eats acorns. You got it when the lights go on. I want to see you magically transform into a squirrel. Let's see you climb a tree. Up at the top of the tree. An acorn. And then back to the bottom of the tree. Those are very good squirrels. And back to sleep, back to sleep. And now, when the lights go on, I want to see you magically transform into sweet, adorable, wonderful children! Children, and guess what? It's story time! Thanks! This week we are reading a really fun book called How to Hide a Lion by Helen Stephens. As always, make sure you pay attention to the story because when we're done reading it, you are going to act the story out and put on the play How to Hide a Lion.
One hot day, a lion strolled into a market square to buy a hat. But the townspeople were scared of lions, so he ran away. He ran as fast and as far as he could and hid in a house in a garden. It was a playhouse, and it belonged to a small girl called Iris. "Can't hide there," said Iris, who wasn't scared of lions. "That house is too small for you." They went inside so Iris could hide the lion properly. They had to be quiet, as mums and dads can be funny about having a lion in the house. The lion let Iris pull the leaves out of his mane. and he showed her his paw where he had stepped on something sharp. "I'll put a plaster on that," said Iris. It wasn't easy hiding a lion. He was just too big, too fluffy, and too heavy, especially when he was asleep. And lions sleep a lot. But when no one was looking, the lion could come out to play. They just had to be careful not to be too noisy. One evening, Iris's dad said, "They still haven't found that lion." "I bet he's a kind lion," said Iris from behind the sofa. "There's no such thing as a kind lion," said her mom. "All lions will eat you." The lion was worried, but Iris comforted him. Then she read him his favorite story. It was about a tiger who came to tea. He fell asleep halfway through because lions sleep a lot. And that was how everything went wrong. Iris heard her mom coming up the stairs, but it's hard to wake a sleeping lion. However, most lions will wake up if a mom screams at them. Ah! The lion raced out of the house and found a hiding place where he could still see Iris whenever she came into town. Nobody noticed him, not the townspeople, not even Iris, and certainly not the two burglars who broke into the town hall and stole every single one of the Lord Mayor's candlesticks. But the lion noticed them. With a huge roar, he leapt off his pedestal and stood on both burglars till the police came. All the townspeople were amazed, except for Iris, who said, "I told you he was a kind lion." And that surprised everyone. Now the lion was a hero. He didn't have to hide anymore. The townspeople held a special parade for him. The mayor said he could have anything he wanted. The lion thought for a moment. Then he asked for a hat, which was all he'd come to town for in the first place. "It really suits you," said Iris.
Okay, who wants to do the play How to Hide a Lion?
I do.
I do. Do you? You do? You feeling shy? Here, I know what. You're gonna be great. Just say, "I believe in myself."
I believe in myself.
I believe in you too. Okay, everybody, places. That means get ready for the big show. All right, everybody, I need you to go grab a stuffed animal. We'll wait. Oh, you got it? You got it. Great. Now, whatever animal you have, I'm going to bestow it with lion powers. Lion powers. The play begins. A lion strolled into the town to buy a hat. That hat looks very nice. But then the townspeople saw the lion and they were terrified.
"Don't stay back, you nasty lion. Stay back, you nasty lion."
The lion ran away. Now, we're gonna play the part of the little kid. Can you play the part of the little kid? You're good at playing the part of the little kid. So the little kid sees the lion and says, "Hi, I'm," and then say your name. So, "Hi, I'm Brooke. Would you like to be my friend?"
"Hi, I'm Hub. Do you wanna be my friend?"
Your turn. "Hi." Yes. Well, the lion would love to be our friend. We're gonna build a house for our lion. So get some wood. Bring it over
this
here.
This is mine.
Yep. And let's start building. Wood, hammer. Can I see you hammer your house? Very good. And what other supplies? A little bit of paint. Can you get some paint? We'll paint the lion's house.
Okay.
Very good. I'm gonna work on mine.
Hold.
Wait, it looks like the house we built is a little too small for our lion, so I think we're gonna have to bring the lion into our real home.
So grown-ups sometimes get a little scared of lions, so let's grab our lion and tiptoe very quietly into the house so the grown-ups don't notice the big, scary lion.
It's not scary.
They think it's scary.
Okay.
We're in the house. Oh, high five. We made it.
Yes.
Okay. Oh, first, we need to clean our lion. So take your lion and clean its mane. Oh, the lion has a little boo-boo. You've got to put a little Band-Aid.
His paw's bleeding.
His paw's bleeding. Okay, let's fix it up. Let me see you fix your little
Band-Aid.
Fix it up, little Band-Aid. Much better, that looks good. You really fixed that lion up. Oh no, someone's coming, we need to hide him. Hide your lion. Everybody, throw, hide your lion, someone's coming. We don't have a lion, nope, not a lion here. Nope. That's just us making all that noise, not a lion.
They still haven't found that lion.
And then kids say, but I bet he's a kind lion. Say that, I bet he's a kind lion.
There's no such thing as a kind lion. All lions will eat you.
Play cool. Nothing to see here. Just the grown-up's gone. Grab your lion, and it's time to jump on the bed. Jump on the bed. That's so fun. Oh, all right, lion. We had fun, but now it is time for bed. So let's put our lion to bed. Let's sing the lion a little lullaby. You are my lion, my only lion. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my lion away. And everybody take your lion and tuck your lion nicely into bed. Good night, lion, I love you.
Mwah. Oh no! A grown-up's coming! Everybody try to wake your lion. Wake up! The lion's not waking up. Lions are so hard to wake up.
Well, that did it. That woke the lion up. The lion starts running. Get your lion. The lion runs away and hides with the statue so nobody knows it's a lion. Let your lion run!
I told you it was a kind lion.
And everybody celebrated together. Friends forever. And you just did the play How to Hide a Lion. Everybody come take a bow. Guess what time is?
Put on your dancing shoes and let's dance.
Dance.
satisfaction. Take me to the stars. To say, ah.
Didn't you? You did. What did you name your bunny? That is the sweetest name ever. Did you have fun with your bunny? Good. Okay, this week I'm going to give you something a little bit crazy. I know it sounds crazy, but we just did a play about a really nice lion, and maybe we shouldn't be so scared of nice lions, because when they're nice lions, right? So I think I'm going to give you a really cute lion cub, a baby lion. Is that crazy? It is, but it's gonna be so fun. So, get ready. I need to warn you, baby lions are a little bit messy, so put any of your nice toys away because they might take them and scratch them, and they're probably gonna scratch the walls a little bit, but it'll be fun. So, put your hands out. This is a nice lion, I promise. Like, a sweet lion cub, you know? Just be nice to him and pet him and give him a name and love him, of course. And you have got to tell me if this lion caused a lot of mischief. I'm expecting some crazy stories about having a lion in your house. Oh, and like we did in the play, if the lion gets too mischievous, just hide him, I guess. Okay, put your hands out. Oh, I guess you're gonna need to get your whole body because this is a big animal. Okay, well, here we go. I'm gonna hand you your very own lion cub. Arm, both arms. I need, yeah,
Get both arms out. Okay, you got him? You ready? Oh! You have a lion cub in your hands. This is wild. Wild. Okay, have fun. Now, you might want to put the lion cub down for just a second. Great. Repeat after me. I am special. I am creative. I am kind. I am silly. I am fun. I am important. And my favorite one, I am me. Yes, because you are the only you, and that is why I love you so much. Thank you so much for being with us this week. We love you. But wait, the party does not have to stop here. Make sure you are following us on Instagram at scampertheatre.com or go to our website, Scamper Theatre, so that you can join our live Zoom dance parties. We are so excited to interact with you and see your faces and see you dancing. Oh, it's the best. We cannot wait. As always, this class is free, but if you would like to donate a few dollars this week, 50% of those proceeds will be going to No Kid Hungry, where we will be helping to provide meals to children who are not getting those meals at school right now. So thank you for that. Of course, we have new classes every Saturday. You can subscribe here. Please like the video, share it, all that stuff. We just want as many kids as possible to get to have fun with us. It means so much to us when we get your emails and videos and everything. So thank you. We love you. We will see you next week and on our Zoom dance party.